Hello, my broodlings, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG Tech. Oh, that doesn't highlight things. I'm still stuck on that. Okay, we just fought a bunch of wolves here. And the sound is very loud for me. Turning it down, you won't notice the difference. More of Adnith's wort, which you've seen before. So exploring more of Magran's Fork. M for map. Quite a bit still to explore. Maybe we should start sneaking, I guess.
Quickly and quietly.
Yep. Not so much quickly, but... just because we're outside doesn't mean we shouldn't sneak up. Be aware of potential foes before they're aware of us, that kind of thing. Nothing there. I really like to clear out an area. So see, we've cleared out the entire top section of this. Ah! A structure of some kind. I'm assuming there's a door somewhere? Oh no! Is this just place just flattened? There's something over there. What we got here? Oh, settler's arrow, okay. I thought that was some kind of decoration on the house. Okay. Looks like we got some kind of dragon wall here. Let's go get our word of power. Oh! Oh, I hate these friggin' things. Oh. What happened with him? No, here's his weapons. Oh, duh. Never mind. Oh, he's still got this active. This defender thing. Let's turn that off. I thought that was only for an encounter, like it would be over at that encounter. So, everybody... I don't remember if arrows work on this thing, but worth a try. Yes, arrows work. I wish there was a quick command to just switch them all back to their weapon sets. You know, like it would get hit R for range and something for melee. Spirit residue. No word of power. No dragon power. Nope, but we got Orleans Cradle. Oh. Ooh, a loose brick. So someone stored a hatchet in there, and lockpicks, and 6 copper. That's pretty interesting of them. I guess we'll go in here. Slow mode. Apparently deserted. A crate with vegetables and fruit. Can I hit shift and... yeah, okay. What's this? Gold rot chew. facts, minus 80 fatigue for 600 seconds, a staple of the Deerwood and countryside, Goldrot Shoe is a favorite of farmers who swear by the minor boost in energy it provides. Those who use it often find that they feel sluggish when they stop. The chew is made from the root of the golden celery plant. Awesome. I got two of them. And more lockpicks.
Eh?
Should I be searching for traps over there? It looks like it could be a trappy thing. How do we get to it? How do we get over there? Can I get closer? Without... Okay, we're fine. Camping supplies? I thought we already used them up. Another rope and grappling hook. Didn't we already have four? Well, we rested after that, didn't we? Okay, never mind. Alright, that's it. Random shack and woods, that kind of thing. I'm really enjoying the way I can put... What, I have caps lock on? I did. So I can name my saves. I like that. Let's continue around the perimeter. Why not?
No problem.
I'm glad you agree. Nice having subjects that, you know, will listen to you. That's the way out. Ruined house. Oh, hello. Who's that? Gold Pack Paladin? Will people react unfavorably if they see you sneaking? Apparently these two guys are seen. So maybe we'll just stop sneaking since they're paladins. Okay, maybe not. Ludranus is there. That one. Get that one. Why? Any reason? Activated Zealous Focus. I don't know what that does. I'm supposing I might find out the hard way at this point. Alright. Well. Why are paladins attacking us? Well, you've attacked the wrong people. This one. Oh, necrotic lance. Oh boy. I'll have him take that. Alright, she's gotta just attack because... She needs more focus. Oh, What? I wanted him to take that. I was on the wrong person's... Ah, crap. I made a boo-boo. Tax fortitude. Okay, see? I click on him. Well, he's down, so never mind. Alrighty then. We fell this guy. This guy's... I kind of want to, like, attack him, but I don't want everyone to get hit by attacks of opportunity here. Eater. Okay. So she's got some focus now. Oh, let's go. Soul Shock. Allied target. Okay. Eater. Oh my god. Oh, this is getting bad. We got her. Now we're just gonna need to get him. Wow. Lots of goodies. Oh, we got the Grimoire of Ludrana. Awesome. Great sword. A mace. Ooh, a wand. Two-handed. As magical implements often lack serious power compared to bows, crossbows, and firearms, the wand's flexible damage types help wizards deal with heavily armored opponents more easily. Wands are easily distinguished from scepters by their tapered points. Cool. There's a large shield and mail armor. Padded armor. Helms. Sugar! Plus one move speed. Ah, gives you sugar rush for 20 seconds. A tin of fine powdery sugar used for sweetening dishes or providing a jolt of energy in a pinch. Silver fennings. Two of them. Two copper pans. Ludrana's orders. It seems I have no choice but to provide you with instruction. Radric's forces are spread thin, and the road through the wilds to the south of Gilded Vale lies unguarded. Given these favorable circumstances, I'm sure that even you can manage to hand a peasant or two. The archers tell me that Kulsk's men made south after their escape. If you should happen to retrieve one of their number, I may be convinced to forgive you your previous mistakes. Kulsk's? Who's one of Kulsk member? Eater? For the last time, you are to keep clear of Defiance Bay. Know that if you cannot be trusted to acquire a useful specimen with even a modicum of discretion, I have no qualms whatsoever about using what materials I have at my disposal instead. Oh. Oh who? O'Shaughnessy? O'Malley? Oh my? Right click for details. Well, I'm right clicking. Got mail armor anyway. Does she? I want Firebrand. Scale armor. Let's get her some mail. I wonder if she could use a shield too. If not, we'll just put it in a wand. Seems good for Aeloth. I thought I gave that to him. I can't give it to him like that. For a small cost, you can learn those spells from the description panel. You may also fill additional grimoires with different spells. Yeah, I know. It locks you out of spell casting. It takes you a while to drag out the book, I guess. I kind of don't want something that slow. Put that in stash. I don't want to mess with her accuracy too much. Mm-hmm. Store everything else in stash, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Put something on, girl. Jeez. I'll put that in the stash. What he has is better. Her grimoire has missiles, fan of flames, ghost blades. Casts a field of unearthly blades into existence, inflicting immediate pierce damage and a hobbled affliction on targets in the area of effect. Chill fog calls a blindingly white icy fog into existence, inflicting blindness on anyone entering and freeze damage over time to any in the area of effect. Fetid caress. The target becomes paralyzed, afflicted with boiling pustules of foul-smelling liquid that erupt from their skin, sickening those nearby. Ew, yeah. It will cost two... What does it cost him money? You know, that's the thing about the game that I don't understand. When you make, like, when you make potions through alchemy, It costs you money. What are you doing, throwing gold into the freaking flask? And it costs you money to put these in your spellbook. Why? Who are you giving the money to? It doesn't make any sense, like in an in-world sense. Well, anyway, these poor fools. How are we doing?
Yeah.
Yeah. I was gonna say, let's take a bat and not use any camping supplies yet. But it's not that much of a bat if we're saving then. Well, let's continue around the perimeter, I guess, and then we'll head up to center. It's interesting, though, how these guys just attacked us.
Sure.
It was their orders. I forget who that guy was, too. I feel ashamed. This guy, what's his name? Kulsk. Kulsk's men. I forget who Kulsk is. A deer. I'm not gonna attack the deer. Kinda wonder how much experience it'll give us. Run, deer. My deer. Some Gyron's horn, it sounds familiar. Yeah, I'm going to the edge. What's with this earth like this? Where's the shadow coming from? Oh, it's a tree, duh. Alright, guys. Huh. Anything else here? Removing the fog of war, little by little. She could probably collect these flowers, right? Can we get closer? Yes? No? No? Back by the shack. That was kind of unrealistic to just, like, walk all over the... Who are you? Durance? Is your first name N? N Durance. Hi.
Saw you in the flame.
That looks like a dangerous staff you got there, sir. Saw me in the flames? Squatting at the base of this statue is an incredibly ugly man with bulging red cheeks rigged by pox scars and a scraggly beard. He is sweating as if he has a fever, but his breathing is measured and steady, like a slow push of a blacksmith's bellows, but that comparison feels strange and unwelcome. The next comparison, possibly sparked by his grin, is that of a bear trap, and then out of nowhere, there's a hint of alchemical fire that fades almost as soon as you identify the smell.
Come to pray at the statue.
The question mark is barely there. As the man makes the statement, the statue takes on a reddish cast, as if one is holding a torch to it, then slowly blossoms into waving flames. The man doesn't turn as the statue blossoms into fire.
The others are welcome. But it's best if just you and I trade words, and your shadows stay quiet. Hands off their weapons, both arcane and steel.
Shadows, huh?
It's only you I want to trade words with anyway.
His face tenses with his iron bear trap smile, ready to spring. This guy seems like he's... he's riding the line between friend and foe, it seems.
I swear before the whore that is Margaret, no harm will come to you in her shadow. If that's enough of a promise for you. If not...
A staff rests easily in his hand. It wasn't there a moment ago. Yeah, it was. He was holding it the whole time. I didn't catch your name, or why you want to speak with me.
I didn't give it. You probably find names as useless as I do. The names that litter this world like debris are hard enough to wrap around the tongue. And what do they matter?
His hand tightens around the staff.
It's what's beneath the skin and the letters I care about. What burns within. It's more important to me you're a watcher than whatever culture or accent decorates your letters like awkward crowns. Take pride in your actions, not where you hail from, or how your name rolls off whatever liar's tongue coats it now.
The man's staff blossoms with fire for a moment, then the embers settle.
If you need a title to hang on me to match your own, watcher, then call me Durance. And as you observe souls, I test them.
What do you mean? Durant shakes his head, and his hand curls tightly on his staff. I can see the questions bubbling up. Let's burn them away, one by one. Sure, I like the sound of that.
I am a missionary. I walk this diseased nation with its heathen... its people so careless with the spirits of others and their own, watchers among them. Yes, I know you for what you are, and your name doesn't interest me. Names are for honest folk, and you are a crack that shines light from another place.
A given name. See if you guys can place that reference.
We're meant to travel together, you and I. Saw you in the flames. Not your face, but that soul of yours. All tightened up, like a huntsman's knot.
You saw my soul in the flames?
There's things we can teach each other. If you're in need of answers to your mantle of questions.
I guess I'm not sure if this guy is... quite all there.
I don't force my words on anyone other than you. I don't care who walks with you or what their mewling problems and politics are. There's enough howling in the world without me stoking that fire.
You got that right.
I won't take from your provisions. Don't need much on the road. I can carry my weight, which is considerable.
He inhales, again giving you the impression of a blacksmith bellows, and he smiles almost proudly. So he's gonna come with us? Sure, why not? I'm getting the idea that the people that you bring on as part of the story, rather than the ones you hire, are gonna actually have a place in this story, and the others are just kinda with you. Because these are scripted NPCs. They have a history behind them, and you get to find out more about them as you go. The ones you hire on, not really. I mean, those are like kind of like they're NPCs. They're not part of your party. They're just... I don't know how to explain it. I'm liking it to pen and paper Dungeons and Dragons.
Many will stand against you. They probably already have, from what I can see. Left their marks, it seems. Like a trail, worming its way behind you.
What kind of marks?
Disease? Spirit wind? Both could have touched you, yet here you stand.
He stares at your face, then into your eyes, almost dully at first, then more intently.
As for disease, not all of us were close to water when the pox hit. But it's no longer a passenger in my flesh. It left its marks as well. But like flames, the pox doesn't strike twice, nor is it catching.
Company would be welcome on the road.
Then let us walk together, Watcher.
Durant says, a face cracks into a smile. I didn't get to ask him how do you know as a Watcher? Let's take a look at this madman. What else does he say?
What? What?
What you got in your hand? What do you have? Why is it yellow like that? It's interesting. Unique quarterstaff, two-handed. Properties: increased reach and burning lash. Nice. He's also got a rod. Oh, you can focus and release soul energy with these? Oh, and with wands? Okay, well, other than that, he doesn't have much. He's a third level priest, excellent! That's what we need, is a priest. Now what about Magran? I'm gonna find out about Magran. I really need to look at this, at these spells. This definitely changes the game up. I met a strange priest in Magran's Fork who claims you have something to gain from questioning one another. Deities. Let's see. Magran. Goddess of war, fire, transformation, purification, consumption, and trials. Patron goddess of the Deerwood. Patron goddess of the Deerwood, thought to have blessed the Godhammer bomb that destroyed Wadwin and possibly... How do you say it? I was saying Eothas and that's wrong. Eothas? Eothas? I don't know. What kind of monsters? Are you finding any new monsters here? Statue of Magran, goddess of war and flame. Dozens of names have been scratched into the stone at her feet, supplicants seeking her blessing. Alright, so...
What?
Look at all these spells he's got. Now, I was reading up about them, but reading in the manual isn't the same as playing. If they're not. Armor of Faith. Barbs of Condemnation. I'll let you guys read the rest. Read the description. So that's a debuff. It's a buff. Divine Terror. Fear Spell. Halt. Cool. Holy Meditation. It's a buff. Prayer against fear. It's a buff against fear. Restore minor endurance. Can I swap these out to have like a couple of these? Excuse me. Oh, it's gonna be pretty. If we can get this up in time, speed is fast. It's got. Use that to protect People like Aeloth, who die after a couple hits. We'll go unconscious. Let's see what to choose. Divine Mark. Burn damage and lowering deflection. Okay. Holy Power. It's a buff. Iconic Projection. Okay, it's kind of like a healing and freeze damage thing. Reducing speed of enemies. Prayer against infirmity. It's a buff. Repulsing seal. Nice. And light endurance. Suppress affliction. Okay.
If it makes you rest easier.
All together, I was just trying to get out of that. Okay. We're running a little over our normal stuff. What was this? West to Gilded Vale, south to Anslog's Compass, east to Black Meadow. Black Meadow. Well, we haven't been there. And where else? South. Okay, so we're going to head to Anslog Compass next. And then what are we doing to get to Defiance Bay? Hugging the coast? Do we have to take this bridge across? Go all the way? Oh no, there's a bridge there, no duh. Alright, so I need to head to get to Madmere Bridge at some point. Alright guys, thanks for watching. See you next time. And enduring, grow strong.